All right, Honey Jefe here. Labor Day, Balderas Apiary Part 2. I'm gonna work through these hives. Got my Hopguard here. It's not everybody's favorite. I can't say that it's my favorite. Got some new gloves here because my last one got holes in them. Got these from Man Lake the other day. It's the same ones that I typically use, but just breaking them in today. No stingers on them yet. I don't want to get hop guard all over them. I'm going to try to cover them with that. I can't work with my bare hands in these hives. I don't care what you say about nitrile gloves. Bees will sting through nitrile. They'll sting through the thickest nitrile. And if you ever been stung a couple of times in your hand, you know it's not comfortable, but try to get stung 50, 60 times. It's even worse. I mean, obviously. So, I don't want 50 or 60 stings through nitrile gloves. Let's see how this works out. I don't think this is going to do well. I can already tell. Because that hops, that mixture in there, that's how I got the holes in my gloves, is I got the hops all over it. So I'll wash my gloves like I normally do. When I pulled it out, they were a different color. They felt like a different texture. And they had holes in them. I think it was because of the setting I had the washer set on. I think I put it on speed washer first, and then I put it on heavy duty. So it was just time for me to get new gloves. I should have started the camera a little bit later, because this is, I'm looking like a big dork. I usually have like multiple boxes of rubber gloves. These are not the best ones. I usually have some good ones, and I ran out. All right. Looks like I've got a bee. That sucker's got a bee. What that is. I'm gonna set this right here. Show everybody how clumsy you are. So I gotta make sure this brood. Little bit of brood, not much, it's not good. Between this, it's not going to be good. I'm looking over at the worker to make sure he's not. A little bit of brood, not much. All right, here's brood. You know, these bees are like flying into this bag. I noticed that they like that smell. So I ordered some oxalic acid, some vegetable glycerin oil, and some sponge. To make extended release, or oxalic acid with extended release over like 3 months. Got a lot of beetles in here. I'm hoping there's brood in the second one, because not a ton down there. There's brood right here. All right. right. So this deep is obviously a brood box. Probably from this hive, as this one is too. And I put them in the superposition. The honey superposition. As we can see, sometimes they'll put brood in there, which is fine with me. I don't use queen excluders. Where I'm going with this is, if there's brood in this top box or in this one, I'm going to use two more strips of Hopguard. So, this is a good comb. Not seeing much on the edge, which is fine. A little nectar in there. A little bit of nectar. I think if I got brood in here, it's going to be more on this right side, because the bottom and the middle, the brood was over here on the right. And it looks like brood. I'm gonna pull it up. Lots of brood. I'm seeing larvae, can't really see eggs, but I didn't see the queen, I probably just crushed her. All right, so how did I have this? All right, so Hopguard. So yeah, it doesn't, it's not treating the mites in the brood. It's just whatever bee walks across this. Since all the bees are trying to keep the brood warm, that's where you want to have it. And of course, as the bees hatch, they're coming out right there. So this is my favorite apiary in terms of what all is going on here. It's a farm, and the owner makes all of his he grows all of his food here. And if you know him, he's got two of the best restaurants. Truly. And I wish I could just video a tour. He may do that one day. He'll give you a tour and show you all the cool things that he's done and that he's doing. I'm gonna come back and put a super on top of this. I think these guys will be okay. Anyway, as far as like hanging out, you know, you can't really just hang out here.
You know,
I got several others that are like on the Red River and kind of hang out. Smoke these guys a little bit. So I think this one can use a super. Looks like there'll be enough brood. They just moved up. And I'm not rotating that bottom one out. I'm basically going to do the same thing. I'm going to put these guys down and then work. So next year I need to spread these out. One strip. good clean comb, big old drone. What am I looking for? I'm looking for brood. A little sparse brood. A little bit better. Not much. And the queen. I'm looking for the queen too. I just want to see. A little better. I don't see a queen. I see evidence. Remember where the dirt is too.
Thank you.
I'm gonna check this box and see if it's a super. Worker's brooding here. Same as this one. Bit of nectar in here, foundation there. I should let that one out. Like all nectar. Capped honey and nectar, uncapped honey. I don't see any evidence of brooding there. I think these guys will benefit from, or be okay with another super. I may try to under super. Six. I've used 10, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Losing this hive here irritated me. That was a one that I swarmed on. Like within a day or like 2 days of me putting it out here. Like I had all the five-frame nuke, put it in the 8 frames. These guys, this foundation on one side here, mm-hmm. All right. A little brood here. A little bit of brood there. I was hoping to see more. In the second box. So I wouldn't have to go down to the bottom box. So I'm going to go in the bottom box. I'll look for brood. Yeah, there's some brood here, not much, but I see larva as well, and it looks like there's a lot more brood over on the other side. All right.
look and see what I see.
A lot more brood over here on the edge. You can look and see where the former strip was at. So I'm putting it kind of rotating sights. I don't know. I want to put a super on there. There's some empty frames of this foundation. In the super there. I think what I want to do. All right, it's just comb. Very little nectar in there. Same. A little busier here. A little nectar in there. All right. Just seeing. This would be good for the fall. Thank you. some brood. It's an outside wall here. Lots of brood here. All right. Just gonna slide over a little bit. Alright, I'll do an after video. What I plan to do is adding the super here because there's brood in all three of these boxes, including this top box. Brood here, I mean, super here. One here, that one seems to have more population. So I'm gonna take a break. cool down. Come back and do that, then I'll shoot a video. Thanks for watching, guys.